So in communication network layer, so once you have determined the influence of the smart object from factor over its transmission capability, you are ready to connect the object to the communicate. Okay, that means the object may be a sensor, communicate is the actuator circuit or any other device. So the various factor need to be considered here, and as the capability of the transmission is the transmission range, data volume and frequency, sensor density, as well as sensor mobility. Okay, here the various sub layers we have considered earlier in the previous session. Those who have not watched my previous session, please watch them. Okay, link I have already shared. So the access network sub layer, here in access network sub layer, there is a direct relationship between the IoT network technology that you choose and the type of connectivity topology this technology allows. Okay, here each technology was designed with a certain number of use cases in the mind. That use cases means what to connect, where to connect. What to connect, obviously sensors and other network related devices to be connected. So where to connect, how much data to transport, and what interval and over what distance it is to be connected. This decision is made under access network sublayer. Okay, so these use cases determine the frequency band that was expected to be most suitable, the frame structure matching the expected data pattern, and the possible topologies that these use cases illustrates. We'll be discussing one diagram as well for this. So here is the diagram. This access technology and its distance coverage is mentioned here. Say near field communication is taken, NFC is taken with a small loop. Okay, followed by, you can see the NFC communication, it is marked as less than 10 centimeter. Okay, up to 5 kilometers we can extend it with a different protocol, but okay, like WPAN, WHAN, WFAN, WLAN, WNAN. Okay, its ranges are not strictly defined, but less than 5 kilometer it may be extended. Then apart from them, up to 100 kilometers we can extend with like mobile communication. What are the technologies we are using right now, no? For mobile communication, the same thing can be used. Cellular licensed network, so WWAN or LPWA or LPWA unlicensed. So about the various protocols, yeah, we'll be discussing what are those meanings are. So for ranges up to 5 kilometers, we can use WPAN, WHAN, WFAN, WLAN, and WNAN. Under WPAN, Bluetooth comes. Okay, Bluetooth is technology. Please note that Bluetooth does not support up to 5 kilometers. This is the one, it can be extended from 10 centimeter onward, like, right, up to certain meters, like up to 5 or 3 to 5 or 10 meters, it can be extended. Right, this is one of the technology. Similarly, Wi-Fi we can use up to, it can be extended for up to 100 meters. Okay, then we have WHAN, one of the important protocol that falls under this category is ZigBee and Z-Wave. Okay, then WFAN, we have wireless HART and ISA 100.11. These are the protocol that can be used here. See, please remember, these are all used for the communication purpose only. Okay, now we are talking about the protocols and methods we can use for communication purpose that could be extended up to 5 kilometer, not 5 kilometer, and the range is not strictly defined, so less than 5 kilometer from 10 centimeter onwards. Okay, then wireless LAN, WLAN. So various protocols under here comes under WLAN are 802.11a, AHP, and AF. Okay, And WNAN, we have WISEN, ZigBee NN, and some other protocols. And for the range of transmission over 5 km up to 100 km, we have to go for cellular network. Okay. So it may use LTE, GPRS, WiMAX and all, that licensed cellular network. And unlicensed cellular network, it uses Sigfox, LoRaWAN, Telensa. So about LoRaWAN and all, we'll be discussing further. Okay. And many other protocols. Then LPWA, one example for this is 3GPP. Okay. Here the meaning of those abbreviations. So they are expanded here. CWPAN stands for Wireless Personal Area Network, Wireless Home Area Network, Wireless Field Area Network, and Wireless Local Area Network, that could be extended up to 5 km. And Wireless Neighborhood Area Network, WNAN stands for Wireless Wide Area Network, WWAN stands for, okay, LPWA stands for Low Power Wide Area Network. Okay, so these are all the groups we are using under this subsystem. So one group is PAN, PAN, personal area network. It could be scaled for few meters. Okay, personal area network up to certain meters it is. So this personal space around a person, a common wireless technology used here is Bluetooth. Well-known technology is Bluetooth. That is what personal area network. So one-to-one communication, normally communication established between two members or two Bluetooth devices, right? Then home area network or HAN, it can be used for scaling of few tens of meters. Okay. So IoT, ZigBee, and Bluetooth low energy protocols are used here. Then we have neighborhood area network or NAN. Then it is used to scale few hundreds of meters. So few tens of meters means HAN, few meters means Bluetooth or personal area network PAN, few tens of meters means HAN, and few hundreds of meters means NAN, neighborhood network, area network. Okay, and FAN, field area network, which scales of several tens of meters to several hundreds of meters, tens to hundreds of meters, and typically refers to an outdoor area, right? General knowledge, outdoor area larger than the single group of house units, that is referred to as FAN. And LAN for local area network, which can scale up to 100 meters, right? This is the commonly used technology that you are aware of. Next is about the network topology. Okay, some topology, commonly used topologies here. One is point to point topology and point to multi point topology. So point to point allows one point to communicate with the another point, right? Point to point, as the name itself tells, and point to multi point topology allows one point to communicate with more than one point. That's it. Okay. This is the this diagram illustrates the topology. The left hand side diagram, which shows the star topology, I hope you are all familiar with this type of topology network because you have studied them in data communication as well as in computer networking. Then next is about the clustered stars. So clustered stars topology, which is clubbing of the star topology, cluster, or defining the star group of stars together as a cluster. So fully functional device and reduced function devices are marked here. Two types of devices marked. So fully functions device, the one which acts as a centralized device which governs the communication, say under star topology, the center node which is having authority, I mean which is having a communication authority with all the nodes, right? This is the node which has got authority of communication with all the other nodes. So this is called as fully functional node, and rest are all considered as the reduced function node. So for example, if this consider, you consider this as A and node B, if A want to communicate with B, then mark it as N. So it has to go through or via N. If C wants to communicate with D, again it has to go through N, right? So hence node N, which is considered as the fully functional node, and the other neighbor nodes or remaining leaf nodes are marked as the reduced functional node. And the same is applicable for the cluster as well. So cluster topology, the collection or clubbing up of the star topology it is. So here there are several nodes marked as the fully functional nodes, okay, cluster nodes. They are responsible for communicate within the devices of that particular network or cluster or the other group, okay, within the group as well as outside the group, they are used to communicate or responsible for the communication. Here we have mesh topology. Mesh topology is the one which is a bit closed topology, as you can see. So it is the difference between the star and mesh topology. Under star topology, what happens? The edge nodes will not be connected to each other. They are only connected to the centralized node, hence it makes the arrangement as star. But under mesh, what happens? The edge nodes, they are also connected. One edge node is connected with another edge node, as you can see here in this diagram. Yeah, this is the connection you can see. This closed surface or area which makes the arrangement as mesh. Okay. This is another example of topology used for the communication